So I think we can start today's class, right? Yes. So in the previous lecture, we were discussing about the singly reinforced beam. Actually, we started the previous lecture with the concept idealized stress strain curve of concrete and steel. We discussed that the characteristic compressive strength of concrete is FCK, but for the structure, it will be around 0.67 FCK due to some slender, due to a factor called slenderness factor. Then after that, for the design, we have to divide that strength with our partial safety factor for material, that is equal to 1.5 for concrete. So if we divide that 0.67 FCK with 1.5, we will be getting the answer as 0.45 FCK. That is the design strength of the concrete, that is 0.645 FCK, correct? Then after that, we discussed about the idealized stress strain curve of the steel, where there also the yield strength of the materials of the steel is around Fy, and if we use the partial safety factor for steel, that is 1.15, we will get the design strength of the steel, which is equal to 0.87 Fy. And just remember the shape of the stress strain curve of concrete, that is idealized stress strain curve of the concrete. The shape of the idealized stress strain curve of the concrete will be a parabola till the strain value 0.002. After that, it will be uniform till the strain value 0.0035. Right, after that we discussed about the assumptions we used in the limit state of flexure, limit state method of collapse flexure. What are the assumptions? Assumption number one, the Bernoulli's assumption, that is plane section before bending will remain plane even after bending. And that's the reason why we can consider the strain variation as linear. Then after that we assume like the maximum strain in the extreme compression fiber in concrete in bending will be equal to 0.0035. And the maximum strain value or the strain value at the level of tension steel should not be less than 0.002 plus Fy divided by 1.15 ES, or 0.002 plus 0.87 Fy divided by ES. And we discussed that the third point was the tensile strength of the concrete is entirely neglected. Tensile strength of the concrete. Concrete will have some tensile strength in bending, that is called modulus of rupture. We will not consider that in the design. We will assume that the tensile strength of the concrete, there is no tensile strength for concrete, or for concrete is not having any tensile strength, right now. Then after that, we started with the singly reinforced beam, where the singly reinforced beam will be providing the reinforcement only in the tension side, and that's our singly reinforced beam. We discussed about the strain diagram, you may be remembering it. Strain diagram will be a linear one with zero value at the neutral axis, with the maximum value of the extreme compression fiber. The maximum value there is 0.0035, and at the level of tension steel, it should not be less than 0.002 plus Fy divided by 1.15 ES. Then after that, we discussed about the stress block also. It is a parabola starting from the neutral axis to a strain value 0.002. After that, it will be uniform till the strain value 0.0035. And the stress value there is 0.45 FCK. Then after that, we discussed about the stress block parameters. What is the X1 value? What is the X2 value? From the top, it is 3/7 XU. From the bottom, from the neutral axis, it is 4/7 XU. Then we calculated the compressive force. We calculate the tensile force. As per IS 456-2000, for a singly reinforced beam, compressive force will be equal to 0.36 FCK XU into B. For tensile force will be equal to 0.87 Fy into ASD. Then after that, we discussed about the lever arm. For finding the lever arm, we needed to find the centroidal distance of the compressive force. That is equal to 0.42 XU, and the lever arm distance will become D minus 0.42 XU. That is the perpendicular distance between the couple forming the forces forming that couple, right now. So D minus 0.42 XU for our singly reinforced beam. Then after that, we discussed about the moment of resistance will be equal to that compressive force into lever arm or tensile force into lever arm. At equilibrium, this will be equal. Then we discussed how to calculate the actual depth of neutral axis. Equation is 0.87 Fy AST divided by 0.36 FCK into B. Then we discussed about the type of sections, that is under reinforced sections, balanced sections and over reinforced sections. We know these details. In which section failure will be brittle in nature? In which section failure will be brittle in nature? Is it in the under reinforced section, or in the over reinforced section, or in the balanced section? In which section of these three, that is under reinforced, over reinforced and balanced section, in which section, which among these three, the failure will be brittle? Yes, exactly. The failure will be brittle in over reinforced section. Why is it brittle in the over reinforced section? Why? Because in over reinforced sections, the concrete will reach its maximum strain value or failure strain value well before steel reaches its yield strain. Right now, steel reaches its that failure strain. So the failure will be there in the concrete, which is brittle in nature, which is sudden in nature. You will not get the sufficient time to escape from there. Right now, it will not give an indication of failure. It will fail suddenly. So similar to that, that over in under reinforced beam is also there. That the steel reaches its yield strain, that failure strain before the concrete reaches its maximum strain. Right now, so there the failure will be in steel. The failure will first occur in the steel. Failure will be ductile in nature, and the ductile failure will give you enough time for the for to escape. Na? So it is ductile in nature. We all the sections will be designed as under reinforced sections. That's the reason why we are designing all the reinforced sections as under reinforced. We have to remember this also. Then after that we discussed how to calculate the XU limit, that is limiting moment of limiting depth of neutral axis. XU limit, we know how to calculate it. We discussed about the MU limit, that is limiting moment of resistance for different grades of steel. XU limit is values different for different grades of steel. Na? That is 0.53D for Fe250, 0.48D for Fe415 and 0.46D for Fe500 grade steel. And MU limit values also there. We will put XU limit in the place of XU. That 0.36 FCK XU max into B into D minus 0.42 XU max. If you place the XU max value for different grades of steel, I will be getting the MU limit value for different grades of steel like 0.148 FCK BD square, 0.138 FCK BD square and 0.133 FCK BD square for Fe250, Fe415 and Fe500 grade steel respectively. Then after that we discussed about the balance percentage of steel. That is the what is balance percentage of steel? The area of steel required for our balanced section. We know how to calculate it, right? Then after that we discussed about the minimum tension reinforcement. As per IS 456-2000, in order to avoid abrupt or sudden failure in single reinforced beams, we have to provide a minimum tension reinforcement or minimum reinforcement in the tension side that is obtained by the equation, that is given in the equation AST divided by BD must be greater than or equal to 0.85 divided by Fy, which depends only on the grade of steel. Right, we solved one question also there. Then after we discussed maximum area of our tension reinforcement. Our IS code limits the use of tension reinforcement to 4% of our gross area. It is gross area, not the effective area. 4% of our gross area, that is the maximum reinforcement we can provide in the tension zone in single reinforced beams. 0.04 into B into capital D. Then after that we discussed some questions, and we were discussing some questions. I think till now everything is clear, and I have given you some questions to solve. I think some of you may have solved those questions also. We'll be discussing those questions, and in the previous lecture there was a question, that last question we have discussed in the previous lecture. I'm going to start with that question. There was a discrepancy, there was a problem when we were discussing that question. So I'll start with that question in this lecture, and we will solve some more questions also. Okay, so I'll start with this. If you're okay with the concepts we have discussed till now, you'll move forward. I need your reply. I think till now everything is clear. I'm expecting like that. Any doubts? Yes, very good, super. So I think we are ready to move further. We are having a question here. You can see it in the secondary screen. A singly reinforced beam section of 200 mm wide and 400 mm effective depth, reinforced with 3 bars of 20 mm diameter mild steel bars. The ultimate moment of resistance of the beam is. So what are the details given? We are given with the breadth of the beam. That is, breadth of the beam is given as 200 mm. The effective depth of the beam is given as 400 mm, and we are given with the AST, that is area of steel, is given as 3 bars of 20 mm dia. 3 bars of 20 mm dia, or we can say 3 into pi into 20 square divided by 4 will give you the area of tension reinforcement. Then after that it is given that FE 250 grade steel, it is given that mild steel bars. Mild steel bar means our the grade of steel is Fe 250 grade steel, or I can consider Fy is equal to 250 Newton per mm square, and grade of steel that is given as M25, that means I can consider FCK as 25 Newton per mm square. So these are the details, these are the values given in the question. We are asked to find the ultimate moment of resistance. So in order to find the ultimate moment of resistance, we have to first check whether it is an under reinforced section or an over reinforced section. in order to judge whether it is an under reinforced section or an over reinforced section, first we have to calculate our actual depth of neutral axis and critical depth of neutral axis, right? How to find the maximum or limiting depth of neutral axis, that is XU limit, will be is equal to 0.53d. The Fe 250 grade steel, for Fe 250 grade steel, Fy will be equal to 250 Newton per mm square. For Fe 250 grade steel, XU max will be equal to 0.53d. Right now, 0.53 into depth of neutral axis will be equal to 400 mm. I think the answer is 212 mm. Right? And after that, we have to find the actual depth of neutral axis. Actual depth of neutral axis, XU, will be equal to 0.87 Fy AST divided by 0.36 FCK XU into B, right? 0.87 FY here is given as 250 Newton per mm square. AST is given as 3 into pi into 20 square divided by 4. That is our area of steel provided. Whole divided by 0.36 into. What is FCK value given? FCK value is given as 25 Newton per mm square. No, it is not 25 Newton per mm square. It is M15 grade steel. It is given as M15 grade steel. For M15 grade steel, it is not 25, it is 15 Newton per mm square. 15 Newton per mm square. FCK value will be equal to 15 Newton per mm square. It will be 15 Newton per mm square. Breadth of the beam is 200 mm. So, what is the value we will be getting here? What is the actual depth of the neutral axis? Yes, I have changed it, no? 15 Newton per mm square. So, what is the XU value? That is the actual depth of neutral axis you will be getting here. Exactly. You will be getting the XU value here as 189.8 mm. If we compare XU and XU max, you can easily find that the actual depth of neutral axis is less than critical depth of neutral axis. That is, XU is less than XU max. Which means that the given section is a under reinforced beam or under reinforced section. The moment of resistance will be equal to the ultimate moment carrying capacity will be equal to, or moment of resistance will be equal to 0.36 FCK XU into B into D minus 0.42 XU. Right now, 0.36 FCK XU into B, that is C into our lever arm. Otherwise, we can use the other equation also, that is 0.87 FY ST into D minus 0.42. Both will give you the same answer. For equilibrium, we can consider C is equal to T. So this will be giving you the ultimate mode of resistance. Here, XU must be considered as this value, that is our XU value. For under reinforced section, axial depth of neutral axis will be equal to 189.8. For this question, I obtained it as 189.8 mm. We have to choose that value here to find the ultimate moment resistance capacity. So, it will be equal to 0.36, FCK will be equal to 15, XU will be equal to 189.8. Breadth will be equal to 200 mm into D minus 0.42 into, what is X value? 189.8. So, if you use the values, you will be getting the answer as, I think it is, you will be getting it as 65.65 kilonewton meter. You will be getting the answer as 65.65 kilonewton meter. If you look at the options, option D is actually almost equal to this value, that is 66. I can go with this answer, that is 66 kilonewton meter. Option D will be the correct answer. Option D will be the correct answer for the question number 1. The ultimate moment carrying capacity of the beam, when the beam is having reinforcement 3 bars of 20 mm diameter bars, then the ultimate moment resistance capacity will be equal to 66 kilonewton meter. I think we followed the same thing in the previous lecture also. But you have given me different answers today, right? You have given me different answer in the previous lecture, I guess, right? Yeah. Those who want to note it down, please note it down. Procedure is same. I think we have followed the same thing till here in the previous lecture also. But while writing the answer, I wrote it as 71 point something as per I was seeing your answers. You might have considered XU max here, that's why you might have got the answer as 72, which is wrong actually. For under reinforced section, we have to consider XU for the design. Okay. Yes, please note it down. So, let's go to the next question. In that question, it is given that the ultimate moment of resistance of the beam if the beam is reinforced with 4 bars of 20 mm dia. So we are changing this ASD value here. Here it was 3 mm 20 mm dia bars, and now we are going to use 4 numbers of 20 mm diameter bars. We are going to use 4 numbers of 20 mm diameter bars. So we have to change the area here, that is 4 numbers of 20 mm dia, 4 numbers of 20 mm diameter bars. Rest of the things will remain same, but here we have to change the area 0.87 FY ASD. In the case of ASD, I have to use this modified value, modified area, that is 0.4 into pi d square divided by 4. So the rest of the things will remain same. So what will be the answer here? What is XE value I will be getting here? Tell me, what is XE value I will be getting here? XE value I will be getting here. Yes, 253.1 mm. That is, I am getting the XE value as, that is, actual depth of total axis as 253.1 mm. Okay, I am going with you. So if you see, if you compare these two, that is our actual depth of total axis, and if you compare it with our critical depth of total axis or maximum depth of total axis or limiting depth of total axis, you can observe that, you can observe that XU is not less than XU max, or XU will be greater than XU max there, right now. So there you can observe, when we compare XU and XU max, you can see that XU value, that is actual depth of total axis, is given that is greater than XU max, which means that the given section is a over reinforced beam. In case of over reinforced beam, to find the ultimate moment of resistance, if it is an over reinforced beam, we will limit the moment carrying capacity. In the equation, that is ultimate moment of resistance or ultimate load carrying capacity will be equal to, you know the equation, na? That is 0.36 FCK XU into B into D minus 0.42 XU. We know this equation for finding the ultimate moment of resistance or moment of resistance of the beam. But here we cannot use this XU value. Why? Because in practically or while during designing, we have to design it as a balanced section. If it is an over reinforced section, or if XU is greater than XU max, we have to limit this XU to XU max. We have to limit it to XU max. And we have already discussed, if we use XU max here in this equation, it will become MU limit. Right now, for Fe 250 grade steel, what is the MU limit equation? MU limit equation will be 0.148 FCK BD square. Right now, 0.148 FCK BD square. Exactly. Tanvir, Angit, yes, you are right. 0.148 FCK BD square. It will be equal to 0.148. What is FCK? 15. And breadth there is given as 200. And the depth there is given as 400 square. So what will be the answer you will be getting? You will be getting something around 72 kilonewton meter will be the answer here. The answer you will be getting here is around 72 kilonewton meter. In the previous lecture also, what we did is same. We have done the same thing here also. We are, but the answer written for the previous question was wrong. That's it. Right now? So you will be getting the answer as, okay, 72 point something. Okay, you can assume it as 72 by, because the options are given like this. Na? Option A, 50 kilonewton meter. Option B, 72 kilonewton meter. Option C, 22 kilonewton meter. And option D, 108 kilonewton meter. So here the answer will be 72 kilonewton meter, and option will be B. Option B will be the correct answer. If you are done with this, we can start solving this question. Try to solve the question. Are you trying or not? I'll read the question for you. The area for or find the area of steel required for a singly reinforced beam using M25 grade concrete and Fe500 grade steel. So we have to use M25 grade steel concrete and Fe500 grade steel. Size of the beam is given as 380 mm by 620 mm. Beam has to be designed for a live load of 20 kN meter over a span of 5 meter, and it is telling us to use a cover of 50 mm. Let's try to write the given values here. Using M25 grade concrete and Fe500 grade steel, size of the beam is given as 380 mm by 620 mm. Beam has to be designed for a live load of 20 kN per meter over a span of 5 meter. And our cover value is also given. That is, cover value, we have to use a cover value of 50 mm. So let's see, let's first write on the things given in the question. So we are given with M25 grade concrete, which will give you FCK is equal to 25 newton per mm square, right? And grade of steel is given as Fe500 which means that Fy will be is equal to 500 Newton per mm square. Right now, then it is given that size of the beam is also given, that is 320 mm. This is the size of the beam given. As the cover value is also mentioned there, the given value is breadth to effective, not effective depth, breadth to overall depth or gross depth of the beam. Then what else is given? Beam has to be designed for a live load of 20 kN per meter. So we have to, that the live load is given, there is live load given, there is, that is, I am going to consider it as LL, will be given as 20 kN per meter. And the length of the beam or the span of the beam, I am consuming it as effective span of beam is also given as 5 meter. And we are given with a cover value. We know what is cover, right? Cover value is given as 50 mm. From this cover value and from this cross-section of the beam, from the size of the beam given, we can easily find that effective depth of the beam will be equal to small d will be equal to overall depth of the beam, that is 620 mm minus our cover value, that is 50, will be equal to 570 mm, will be the effective depth of the beam. So these are the things given in the question, and we are asked to find the area of steel reinforcement required. That is, I have to find the ASUL. This is actually a design question. This is how we are going to design. By design means we have to find the area of steel required for the chosen cross section of the beam. So how to do this? Any idea how to do this? In the beginning or beginning of RCC, I have told you the first step in the design will be, what is the first step in the design of a structure? What will be the first step in the design of a structure? What is the first step in the design of a structure? What happened? Exactly, we have to go for the load calculation. Vishwardhan, super, very good. We have to go for the load calculation. Here we are given with the load, that is, live load is given in the question, that is 20 kN per meter. Yes, Tanbir, Anindida, yes, very good. Ramesh, yes, super. So we have to calculate the load calculation, right? We have to go for the load calculation. Here it is given that live load, I am going to write it like this, live load is given as 20 kN per meter. This is the live load, only live load is considered here. But for a structure, we are having a similar support beam here, na? For a structure, there will be dead load also will be there, na? There will be dead load also. So we have to consider that dead load also. So we have to calculate the dead load acting in the beam. How to find the dead load? Dead load will be equal to a density of concrete into cross-sectional area or gross area of the beam. Density of concrete, we can consider it as 25 kN per meter cube. And our cross-sectional area will be, we have to take the gross area of the beam. That is 380 mm divided by 620 mm. Or we can say 0.38 into 0.620. What is the total load? What is the dead load there? Tell me the value of dead load. Please be ready with your calculator. I need your answers. 25 into 0.38 into 0.620. What is the load you will be getting there? Exactly. 5.65 kN per meter. You will be getting the answer here as, that is, dead load as 5.65 kN per meter. Yes. Yes. Angit, Nisha, Hubli. Yes. Super. 5.89. I'll be going with then 5.89. Okay. I'll be going with 5.89 kN per meter. I think, Hubli, just check your answer once again. 5.89 kN per meter. Then what will be the total load? Total load here will be is equal to dead load plus live load. Correct, na? Dead load here is 5.89. Live load here is 20 kN per meter. It will become 25.89 kN per meter. Tell me, for the design, will I choose this value? No, I cannot choose this value. I have to multiply it with the partial safety factor for loads. What is the partial safety factor should I consider? For dead load, live load combination, what is the partial safety factor should I consider? Please reply. Exactly, it is 1.5. As the problem is not involved, as the reversal of stresses or stability of the structure is not involved in the question, we have to go with the partial stability factor 1.5. So design load will be equal to that is partial safety factor for load, that is 1.5 for dead load live load combination into 25.89. Give me the answer here. 1.5 into 25.89. What is the answer? 38.835. Right now? 38.835 kilonewton per meter will be the our design load. Correct? Yes. The answer here will be 38.835 kilonewton per meter. Right, so I have to calculate, this is a flexural member, singly reinforced beam, I have to calculate the design moment. Na? So I am going with the design moment, I am going to calculate the design moment. How to find the design moment? How to find the design moment or the ultimate moment or mu? I am going to call it as mu. How to find the mu? We know, if you are having a beam like this, suppose we are having the beam like this, it will be having live load, lead load combination will be a uniformly distributed load. That is, a live load plus lead load will be acting in the beam like this. Will be a uniformly distributed load. What is the maximum minimum there? The maximum minimum will be there will be equal to WL square by 8. We know the value of W now. What is W here? That is 38.835. What is L? L is the effective span which is already given in the question, that is 5 meter. Then 8 is also there. Tell me the value of Exactly. Tell me the value of design bending moment. Mu is equal to W L square divided by 8 and 38.835 into L square. L square here is 5 square divided by 8. What is the answer? You will be getting it somewhere around 121 point something. Exactly. 121.36 kilonewton meter. That will be our design moment. Which means that we have to design this beam for a moment of 121.36. So I am going to include this here. That is the ultimate moment or the moment to be for which the beam has to be designed is equal to 121.35 kilonewton meter. We will be designing the beam for this moment. That is 121.35. Right now. So you have to move further. Please note it down till here. After that we will continue. Please note it down. We have to go with the moment of, we have to design this beam for the moment of 121.35. I will be getting that moment by considering this load value, that is 20. I have to consider the dead load also. For finding the dead load, density of concrete into gross area. Sometimes it will be taken as 24 kilonewton per meter cube also. Okay. If it is given in the question, you can go with that value. Otherwise, you have to choose the 25 kilonewton per meter cube. And take the value, you will be getting as 5.89. Add them, you will be getting the total load. Find the design load, find the design moment, that is W square by 8, and you are going to use that value for the design of our B. Okay, make it fast. So now we have the moment or the beam, the moment which has to be taken, which has to be carried by this beam, that is 1.35 kilonewton meter, right? Now? And we have to find the area of steel required to calculate to take care of this beam take this beam, right? The area of steel required for this moment. What is the area of steel required? Area of steel to be provided for our single reinforced beam to carry this amount of moment, right? Now, so the equation for finding moment. What is the equation for finding moment? You already know this. We have discussed in the previous lecture. 0.87 Fy Ast into d minus 0.42 x cube will be giving you the moment value, which is actually our equation for moment of resistance. So now we know the moment to be a moment for which the beam has to be designed, right? Now, so this is the moment for which the beam has to be designed. That is mu is equal to 121.35 kilonewton meter will be the moment for which we have to design the beam. So we already know mu, that is moment, will be equal to, we know the equation for finding the moment of resistance will be equal to 0.87 Fy Ast into d minus 0.42 x u. Right now, if you see this equation, we can see that we have to find the area of steel required to carry this moment, right? We can use this equation for finding the Ast, but there is a problem. In this equation, what are the unknowns? Fy is an unknown, but we have the value, that is Fy is given as 500 Newton per mm square, or the grade of steel is given as Fe 500. But depth is also given. What is the depth given in the question? Depth given in the question is 620 mm. That is the overall depth. Effective depth is 570 mm. But XU value is not there. XU value will not be given in the question. Now I have to find the XU value. If I know the XU value, and if I put all the values here, if I put the values of D, XU and FY here, I can easily find the AST value. Why? Because AST is the only one unknown there. Correct now? How to find the XU value? Any idea? Can you give me your ideas? How to find the XU value? How I can find the XU value? Yes. This is not the only one equation I have to find the, this is not the only one equation I have to, this is not the only one equation which is available for me to find the moment of resistance. Right now? Moment is also equal to compressive force into lever arm. What is the compressive force? 0.36 FCK XU into B into D minus 0.42 XU. Use this equation for finding the XU value. What is 0.36 FCK and XU? 0.36. What is FCK value? FCK is 15 given and XU is actually an unknown. Breadth given is 380 mm. Right now? And depth is given as 570 mm. Don't take this value, that is 620 mm, which is going to give you a wrong answer. Why? Because it is the overall depth of the beam. 570 mm minus 0.42. What is XU value? XU is an unknown. So use this equation, will be equal to 121.35 kilonewton meter. Here all the terms are have taken in mm. So I am going to convert it into mm, that is Newton mm. So you will be getting the answer as, XU is in mm. So tell me the answer for XU. What is the value you will be getting here for XU? Tell me the value you will be getting here for XU. What is XU value there? I think you will be getting the answer as 65.40, right? Yes, exactly. 65.40 mm will be the XU value which you will be getting from this equation. And if I apply this value here in this equation, you are going to get the AST value. Apply that value there. AST will be equal to, what is AST will be? AST will be equal to, from this equation, which equation? From this equation, AST will be equal to 121.35 into 10 power 6 Newton mm, the whole divided by 0.87. What is FY value? 500 into D minus, D is 570, remember D is actually our effective depth of the beam, not the overall depth. 570 minus 0.42 XU here is 65.40 mm. And if you use this value, you will be getting the AST value. What is the AST value? What is the area of steel required for this beam? What is the area of steel required for this beam? I think most of you are going to get the answer as 514 mm square. That is AST you are going to get here as 514. That is 514. I can say 514 point something. That is, I am going to say 514.6 mm square will be the area of steel required for our beam. 514 mm square will be the area of steel required for our beam. That's the answer. Find the area of steel required for our singly reinforced beam using M25 grade concrete and FE500 grade steel. Size of the beam was also given, load was also given. This will be the area required for our beam. Right now? Yes. Please go for it. Note it down. I think you all got the value. But sometimes now there is a gate question. I'll give you the idea. Try to solve that gate question. See, what will happen? I think that is not a gate question. I think it is an IGS question. But still, I want to give you that idea. Okay. Sometimes now he will ask you the question like this. Here he has asked the question like this. Find the area of the tension reinforcement. Sometimes he will ask you the question like this. Find the number of 20 mm diameter bars required for this beam. Can you just find the number of 20 mm diameter bars required here in this beam? The area of steel required here is 514.6 mm square. Find the number of 20 mm diameter bars required, to be provided for this beam. Can you find this? Yes, this is not a part of this question. This is not the part of the question. The question ends here. That is the area of steel required for this beam. That is the question ends here. That is 514 Newton per mm square. But I am just extending this question further. I am asking you the question. What is the number of 20 mm diameter bars required for this beam? Right? Here the area of steel, I will tell you how to do that. The total area of steel required in the tension zone or in the beam for the singly supported beam, singly reinforced beam is around 514.6 mm square. I am asking you the number of reinforcement required here. I am asking you the number of 20 mm diameter bars required. So let's find the area of a single reinforcement. Area of 20 mm diameter bar. I'm going to denote it as AST. That is small AST will be equal to pi by 4 into 20 square. This is the area of a single reinforcement, right? That is single 20 mm diameter bar. And if I divide the total area with the area of one reinforcement, I will be getting the number of 20 mm bars required. I will be getting the number of 20 mm diameter bars. If I divide this total area with the area of single reinforcement, number of 20 mm diameter bars required will be is equal to total area, that is 514.6 mm square divided by pi by 4 into 20 square. What is the answer you are getting? Tell me the exact answer. 1.63 bars. Okay, 1.63 bars you have to provide. But generally we cannot provide this 1.63. Na? That is generally practically not possible. We are going to take a higher value, that is 2 bars has to be provided. We will be providing 2 bars or 2 bars of 20 mm diameter. We will be providing 2 bars of 20 mm diameter bars for this beam, singular reinforced beam, to carry the load or live load of 20 kN per meter. Remember, if you provide this much area, the section will be safe. The live load for which the beam has to be designed was 20, but we have calculated the dead load, we have calculated the design load, let's calculate the design moment, and we have calculated the area. And by using this process, if you follow this process or procedure, we'll be getting a safe section. We are designing, see, actual load was 20, but we are designing it for a higher value. Now, we have discussed in the basics of limit state method of design, right? We will be overestimating the load so that we will be getting a safe section. So, here the number of reinforcement required will be 2. 2 reinforcement bars of 20 mm diameter bars. 2 numbers of 20 mm diameter bars. That will be your answer. If you are using a 25 mm diameter bar, the number of bars will be somewhat different, right? Number of bars will be maybe a bit less. If you are using 60 mm diameter bar, it will be somewhat less. So that's the it will be more than 2. If you are using 60 mm diameter bars, the number of bars required will be more. Please note it down. Can you tell me? I'll discuss one extra point here. If you want, you can just remember this, but no need to remember. I'm going to ask you what are the various diameter of bars available in the market in India. The different diameter of bars available in the market in India. I'm going to ask you this question. What are the different diameter of bars or the diameter of the bars available in India? See, we'll be having 5, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 is not there, 16, 18 is okay, we can write it there, 20, 22, 25, 28, 32, 36, 40, 45, 50, like that. These are the different diameter of bars available with us, that is 5 mm diameter bars, 6 mm diameter bars, 10 mm, 12 mm, 16 mm, 18 mm, 20 mm, 22 mm, 25 mm, like that till 50 mm. These are the different diameter of bars available with us. But generally, most commonly used are 6, 8, 10, 12, 16 will be there, 20, 25, and we'll be using 32 and like that. These are the main commonly used reinforcements. Right now, this 60 to 12 mm diameter bars will be used as distribution bars. We'll be discussing it in the slabs. And remaining from 20 to 32 will be using it for the beams like that. So not required for gear exam and all. They will be giving you the diameter of the bars. But if for a general information, I'm telling you like this. Okay. Yeah. Please note it down if you want. Don't try to mark them up. No, not required actually. In this question actually, it was not a numerical answer type question. It was a multiple choice question. You were given with options also. I have not included the option here in this question due to the limitation of the space there. I wanted to discuss those two questions in a single slide. Okay, that's why I have not included that. So, yes, these answers were in the options. Okay, this was the answer given by our Varsha, that is 130.81. These were in the options. Let's see the question first and we'll discuss all the things. Okay, yeah. So, the question is,
In the design of the beams, there is limit state of collapse and flexure as per IS 56-2000. Let the maximum strain in the concrete is limited to 0.0025. Find option A, the depth of the nodal axis for the balance section. Let's start with one by one. Okay, I'm going to start with the first question, that is depth of the nodal axis for the balance section, and we are given with the breadth of the beam 250 mm, effective depth of the beam 350 mm, AST is also given there, that is 1500 mm square, FCK is given as 30 MPa, that is M30 grade concrete, FY is given as FY 250 MPa, that is FE 250 grade steel or mild steel bar. So given data or given details are, or given that breadth of the beam is given, that is either 250 mm, right? Yes, it is 250 mm. Effective depth of the beam is given as 450 mm, I guess. Yes, no, sorry, 350 mm. Breadth is given as 250 mm. Depth is given as 350 mm. AST is also given, that is area of steel in the tension phase is given as 1500 mm square. And we are given with FCK, that is characteristic compressive strength of the concrete at the end of 28 days is also given that 30 Newton per mm square. We are given with the FY value for FE 250 grade steel, FY value will be equal to 250 Newton per mm square will be the FY value. And it is given that the maximum strain in the extreme compression fiber is given as 0.0025. This is the tricky part in this question. Why? Because the equations we have studied till now, that is, we are asked to find the depth of nodal axis for the balance section. What is the depth of nodal axis for the balance section? That is XU limit or XU max. You know that the depth of nodal axis for the balance section is XU limit or XU max. What is the XU max value for the given grade of steel? What is XU max value for FE 250 grade steel as per IS 456-2000? As per IS 456-2000, what is XU max value for FE 250 grade steel? It is 0.53D. Right now, for the XU max value, that is the depth of nodal axis for the balance section means, the depth of nodal axis for the balance section means XU limit or XU max. The XU max value for the balance section FE 250 grade steel is 0.53D, that is as per IS 456-2000. As per IS 456-2000, the maximum strain in the extreme compression fiber was 0.0035. Here it is not 0.0035, it is 0.0025. So I have to calculate that everything will be changed. Everything will be changed. So I am going to consider the strain diagram here. What is the strain diagram here? The strain diagram here will be a linear one due to the first assumption. What is the first assumption? Assumption number one is, what is the assumption? Assumption number one is the strain, so the plane section before bending will remain plane even after bending. So it will give a linear strain distribution. This is actually our neutral axis. This is our neutral axis. And this value here will be equal to, this value here will be equal to 0.0025. This will be 0.0025, and for balance section, this will be our XU max. For balance section, XU can be considered as XU max. Here, no change is there in the tension steel. The strain value here will be equal to 0.002 plus Fy divided by 1.15 ES will be the strain value at the level of tension steel. And this distance, this remaining distance will be, if it is XU max, it will become D minus XU max, right or not? This will become D minus XU max, correct? Yes. Now we can find the limiting depth of nodal axis, that is XU max. How to find the XU max value here? From the similar triangle principle. From the similar triangle principle, I can easily find the XU max value. Nah? So XU max value, to find the XU max value, why? How to find the XU max value? 0 point from the similar triangles, 0.0025 divided by XU max will be is equal to 0.002 plus FY divided by 1.15 ES the whole divided by, what's the value here? Here will be D minus XU max. D minus XU max. If I take it here, it will become D minus XU max, the whole divided by XU max is equal to 0.002 plus FY divided by 1.15 ES the whole divided by 0.0025. Right? Otherwise, I can write here like this. D minus XU max divided by XU max, which will become D by XU max minus XU max by XU max, which will become D by XU max minus 1. Correct? Na? Or I can write it like this. Listen here, everyone. I'm going to rewrite this equation. D minus XU max divided by XU max will become D by XU max minus 1. What is the unknown I want to find? I have to find the XU max value. Depth of the beam given, that is 350 mm. So apply the value here, depth of the beam. And I can use the depth of the value, the depth of the beam value there. Fy I can give. What is the Fy value given? 250 Nm per mm square. What is the ES value? What is the ES value? ES value is 2 into 10 power 5 Newton per mm square. So we have that value also. So put all the values, find the value of XU max. What is the XU max value you will be getting here? Tell me what is XU max value you will be getting here? If I put all the values, what is XU max value you will be getting here? Put all the values, I think you will be getting the answer as 156 point something. Right now? You will be getting the answer as 156 point something. Yes, exactly. You will be getting the answer here as 156.1 mm will be the depth of neutral axis for the balance section. Varsha is saying that 131.81, Vishnu 131.81. Yes, why? Because a thing like this, why? Because you might have used that concept, that is C is equal to T. If you use C is equal to T, the depth of neutral axis you are going to get there is actual depth of neutral axis. Not the maximum depth of neutral axis or not the depth of neutral axis for the balance section. What is XU limit? XU limit is the depth of neutral axis for the balance section. We have defined it in the previous lecture. No? XU max or XU limit is the depth of neutral axis for the balance section or the maximum depth of neutral axis. So if they are asking you the limiting depth of neutral axis or maximum depth of neutral axis or balance depth of neutral axis or depth of neutral axis for the balance section, we have to follow this procedure for finding the depth of neutral axis. Depth of neutral axis for the balance section, as per the given details, will be is equal to 156.1 mm. This was also there in the options, 136 point something. This was also there in the options. Okay, so answer here will be 156.6 mm. Okay, 61 or maybe 156 6 mm. Right now, so this will be our answer. Our answer will be 156.1 mm. Okay, so go this. Please note down. Right. So I go to the next question. That is the second part of the question. At the limit of state of flexure, the force acting on the compression zone of the section is. We are asked to find the force acting on the compression zone of the section is. So I'll solve this here. How to find the force acting in the compression zone? What is the equation for the compressive force? Compressive force here will be equal to 0.36 FCK XU into B, right? C will be equal to 0.36 FCK XU into B. If you are using this equation, you are going to get a wrong answer. Why? We cannot use this equation here. Why? Why we cannot use this equation? We cannot use this equation for finding the compressive force. Why we cannot use this equation? Anyone? We have discussed in the previous lecture. Why we cannot use this compressive force equation? Exactly. The stress flow parameters will change. Why it is changing? Why? Because the strain value given here is different. Are you getting it? The strain value given here is different. If any of these things are changing with respect to our assumptions we have taken, the entire values will be changed. C will not be equal to 0.36 FCK XU into B. So we cannot use this equation. Remember this. Some of you will be using this equation and they will be getting an answer. There will be an option waiting for them. Okay, right. So don't go for this. So to find the compressive force, we have to draw the stress block first. So to draw the stress block, we know how to draw the stress block, right? So there will be tensile force here. This is our tensile force, and it will be a parabola till the strain value 0.002. Now it will become XU, right? I'm not going to consider as XU max. It will be XU. Not for the balance section. I'm going to take it as XU. So this will be our parabola, and after that it will be uniform till the strain value 0.0025, not 35. So here the stress value here is 0.45 FCK. Now in order to find the compressive force, we have discussed in the previous lecture, the compressive force will be equal to compressive force, or I'm going to write it as C, will be equal to area of stress block, area of stress block into, what is area of stress block into? Breadth. Area of stress block into breadth. Correct or not? Area of stress block into breadth. So to find the area of stress block, we have to find, first find the area of this parabolic portion. After that, I have to find the area of this rectangular portion. You don't have to find the area of this parabolic portion. I need this distance. I need this distance and I need this distance. If I take it as x1 or x2, if I take it as x1, what is the value of x1? Some of you will think that x1 will be equal to 4 by 7 xu, x2 is equal to 3 by 7 xu. Is this correct? It is also wrong. Why? Because we obtained this by from the strain diagram. But here the strain value is different. So this value, x1, x2 value will also be different. Let's first find the x1, x2 values there. Well, how to find the x1, x2 values? 0.0025 divided by xu will be equal to 0.002 divided by x1. From this, x1 will be equal to 0.8xu and x2 will be equal to 0.2xu. Right now? X1 will be equal to 0.8xu and x2 will be equal to 0.2xu. Right now, this is 0.2xu, then this is 0.8xu. Correct or not? Right now? Yeah. So we are going to use these values for finding the compressive force. Now we can easily find the compressive force. First find the area of this parabola. First, after that, find the area of this rectangular portion. So compressive force will be equal to, what is the area of this parabola? Parabolic portion area will be equal to 2 by 3 into b into h. What is the b there? 0.45 fck. 0.45 fck into, what is the x1 value? X1 value will be equal to 0.8xu plus, and area for rectangular portion 0.45 fck into 0.2xu will be giving you the total compressive force. What is the total compressive force? What is the total compressive force? 0.36 fck xu into b. Very good. So we are, have to multiply it with b also, no? B is also there, breadth is also there. So it will be equal to 0.33 fck xu into b will be the compressive force here in this b. Here for the given strain value, the compressive force here will be equal to 0.33 fck xu into b. Right or not? Yes. Now find the xu max value. So you find the compressive force value. C will be equal to 0.33. fck value there is, I think, 30. And what is xu value? Xu value is 156.1. xu will be equal to 156.1. into, what is the breadth value? Breadth value is 250 mm. What's the answer will be getting? I think you'll be getting it as around 368, right? 386. Okay, you'll be getting the answer as 386. Kilo newton meter. But this is gate exam actually. This is gate exam. This was option B. This was there in the option B. This answer is wrong. This answer is wrong. Why it is wrong? His answer is wrong. Why it is wrong? Why it is wrong? Why it is wrong? We are using XU max here. It's actually our mind, no? He is playing with our mind. He will ask you the XU max first, and he already knows. Some of you are going to use this value XU max. After calculating this, we are going to use this value here for calculating the compressive force. Even if you take care of all the things, but if you are using this value there, you are going to get a wrong answer. But I told you in the previous lecture, he is not going to disappoint you in the examination hall. This is given in option B. This is wrong. So we cannot go for this. First we have to find this XU value, that is axial depth of neutral axis. I have to first find the XU value. After that only I can find the compressive force. Now how to find the XU value? How to find the XU value? I think Anindita, you got the wrong answer, but it's completely fine. No issues are there. Understand and don't repeat this. That's the only one thing you have to do. Okay? Anindita, fine. So, how to find the XU value? For equilibrium, we already know this compressive force will be equal to tensile force, na? This compressive force will be equal to tensile force. What's the compressive force? 0.33 fck xu into b is equal to, what's the tensile force? 0.87 fy into asd. All the values are given. We know what is the value of fck, 30 newton per mm square. We know the value of b, that is 250 mm. We know the value of fy, that is 250 newton per mm square. We know the value of asd, that is 1500 mm square. From by using these values, I can easily find the xu value. What's the xu value you'll be getting here? What is the x value you will be getting here? I think you will be getting the x value as 131 point something. Right? What is the x value? I am going to consider as 131 point something. Tell me the x value is? Exactly. 131.8 mm. You will be getting the x value as 131.8 mm. Now we can find the compressive force. Right? Now we can find the compressive force. I am writing it here. The compressive force here will be equal to, put the value, put this value back into this equation. Which equation? This equation. Right? Compressive force will be equal to 0.33 fck xu into b, right? 0.33 fck xu into b, 0.33 fck will be equal to 30, xu there will be equal to 131.8. Remember this, it is not 156.1, it is 131.8 into breadth is given as 250 mm. Tell me the compressive force value. Tell me the compressive force value. Tell me the compressive force value, please. You'll be getting it around 326, right now? Exactly. You'll be getting the answer as 326.2 kilonewton meter will be. Sorry, kilonewton will be the compressive force in this beam. 326.2 is superb. 326.224 will be, 22 kilonewton will be the compressive force in the beam. 326.2 will be the answer. Answer, I think it was option C. I have not included the option here. Sorry for that. It was option C, I guess, that is 326.2. But remember, for your knowledge, I got one value by using this xu max value also, no? That is C is equal to, I think you get to go to around 386 point something. It was also there in the option. So, go with our xu value here in this question. Okay? So, answer here will be equal to 326.2 kilonewton. You know the reason why, right? Why we cannot use this xu max value, no? Why? Because in compressive force, we have to use the actual local axis, right? So answer here will be 326.2.